Hachette Audio presents Hollywood Said No, orphaned film scripts, bastard scenes, and abandoned darlings from the creators of Mr. Show. Written by Bob Odenkirk, David Cross, with Brian Posehn. Performed by a full cast.
Hey everybody, it's Bob and David!
We want to wish you luck with your long drive across America. We assume that's why you have this book.
Or, yeah, you could be on a subway or a bus. Or,
right. We're sorry about the bus. Sorry about that guy, that stinky guy, three rows in front of you. He should shower. You're right. Everyone should shower.
Don't judge, because he's reading Nietzsche. So,
right.
You know.
He's not wasting his time getting clean.
Right, or listening to these jibber-jabbers.
Yeah.
Now, before we begin, we would like to go to the old future and answer our most asked question about this little book. And let's go to the old mailbag now. Let's find it.
Where's the mailbag?
I've got it. I'm walking. It's in the room over here.
I can hear your footsteps.
All right.
You've gained a lot of weight. And how come it's so echoey in here?
Bob, which mailbag? I know we're going for future mailbag, but what?
Reach up top. No, don't knock it all off.
Wetter than I thought.
Well, I store water on top of the mailbags. I store all our emergency water, and I'm sorry, now it's on you.
Well, at least it's water. I thought it could be something else. All right, good. All right, well, I picked out this letter just at random. Let's listen to it.
Dear Bob and David, so what? You think if you publish your stupid screenplays that somebody in Hollyweird will actually read them and go, oh my God, we screwed up so bad, we didn't make this genius screenplay. We better fix this right away and apologize to these guys and make all their badly plotted half-assed comedy screenplays before they, get us in trouble with the comedy police? I mean, I read your screenplays, and yeah, there were some laughs in there, but they were also kind of sloppy and way too satirical. Nobody likes satire that much. Figure it out already. Anyway, I'm a fan of some of your work. I've written a few screenplays myself, but you don't see me trying to publish it and cutting down the last remaining trees so I can have a pity party in public. Anyway, good luck, I guess. And hey, if you'd read one of my screenplays, I'd appreciate it. I got one that's about these two guys named Dob and Bavid who catch a chupacabra and train it. It's kind of an updated cinema verite, How to Train Your Dragon. Sincerely, George Sandorsky. By the way, doesn't have to be cinema verite. It can be mockumentary or animation, or it could be a TV show or anything.
Wow, thanks for your letter from the future, George. And now here's our answer. No, we don't think Hollywood people will read this book and think they made a mistake. We'll get to that in the introduction.
Yeah, we're publishing them because we, like you, are fans of some of our work. Now, where we disagree with you is in your dismissive reference to us cutting down trees.
The trees have been man's worst enemy on Earth since the dawn of creation. Guess who killed the dinosaurs? The trees did.
Yep.
It's them or us, and this is one small step in the right direction. Lastly, yes, we will read your screenplay.
Oh, God, that sounds wonderful. Two guys who train a legendary mystical creature from south of the border? Come on. It's got international sales written all over it in green ink.
Yeah, if it's not a problem, we would like to make it an animated mockumentary for the web only. Send it ASAP. This is gonna go good.
Absolutely. Now, to everyone else, welcome to the book of screenplays that never got made. We hope you get some laughs out of it.
Introduction. A brief history and context of the scripts herein.
Ah, Hollywood. You giveth and taketh away like a colicky two-year-old being fed oysters. One never knows what gems or turds will manage to squirt through Hollywood's labyrinthine system and get made. Their filmic fate then to be decided upon by an even more fickle populace. Will it be Animal House or will it be Biodome? One can never be certain. We got to make a movie once, but more on that later. For you see...
You hold in your hands a couple of movie scripts, and then some, that we wrote in reasonable anticipation of being able to get them made. Meaning, these scripts were written after ending the run of Mr. Show with Bob and David. And, with that small yet real measure of success in mind, the obvious next step for our ragtag group was to write and make a movie. And of course, why wouldn't we? Corky Romano? Beverly Hills Ninja? Snowboard Academy? Joe Dirt? With these and several others as examples of the then-current crop of comedies getting made, why wouldn't we believe a Mr. Show movie could do the box office business that the aforementioned movies would do? And hopefully, the business would be just enough to allow us to make more films.
Well, we, along with fellow Mr. Show writer-performers Scott Aukerman, B.J. Porter, and Brian Posehn, did write that movie. And Troy Miller, our director-producer extraordinaire at Mr. Show, directed and edited it. It was called Run, Ronnie, Run, and it wasn't very good, unfortunately. But enough virtual ink has been spilled on that sorry saga, and if you bought this book, it's probably safe to assume you know the tortured history of it already and don't need to hear our rehashed whining again.
But it does provide context for this book and helps answer the rhetorical question, why exactly are we putting out a book of film scripts that never got made? Well, because we think they're funny and that you'll enjoy reading them.
The first one we wrote, chronologically, is Hooray for America. Hooray is a more high-concept story than we had explored on Mr. Show, but the kind of thing we may have progressed towards if there were to have been a fifth season. It's a linear story where we and the Mr. Show cast would play multiple roles, and there are several different tones of comedy represented.
But we decided that perhaps it was too high-concept to be our first movie, so we went back to the drawing board, and that's where Run, Ronnie, Run came in, and well, we all know how that turned out. But we were determined to make a movie, so it was back to the drawing board. This time, we decided to give America what it really needed, a great sketch movie. This was Bob and David Make a Movie. It is the first script you will encounter in this book.
We were convinced we might actually be able to persuade someone in Hollywood, anyone, to finance a script and get it made. In other words, cheap, not particularly challenging, and unarguably funny. We didn't know that we had reached our nadir yet.
Bob and David Make a Movie starts immediately with us talking to each other and to camera. It feels very familiar to the first few minutes of a Mr. Show episode. We greet the audience and each other, a situation presents itself, it quickly spins into something else entirely, then leads into our first sketch, and ultimately winds up back around to a satisfying ending which recalls the beginning. Much simpler than Hooray, more Bob and Davidy than Run, Ronnie, Run, and much, much more like Mr. Show, the lady that brought us to the dance in the first place, as it were. And the fact that we and our cast, again, would play multiple roles in that story as well was always exciting for us.
Needless to say, Hooray for America and Bob and David Make a Movie were never made, and never will be. They were written for two exciting, up-and-coming comedy writer actors in their late 30s who were coming off of a still-relevant cult comedy show to make. That ship has not only sailed, but has been dry-docked and turned into a museum.
But know that there is no bitterness here. We're happy in our lives and professions. Often things don't work out like one would hope. Let's go to prison, freak show. And sometimes they do. Breaking Bad, Arrested Development, that's life. But we decided that rather than have all this stuff languish on a couple of bookshelves in Brooklyn and L.A., we'd release them into the wild, complete with reminiscences, illustrations, and extra jokey jokes for you to enjoy.
Which we truly hope you do. See you in 2015.
Bob and David.
Ladies and gentlemen, Hooray for America!
Hooray for America by Bob Odenkirk and David Cross, written sometime in 1999. Open on, a paragraph on screen. The following is a work of fiction. Current U.S. election laws make it impossible for any single corporation to buy the presidency. Dip to black, then up on. However, we're working on it. Burn in Globochem logo, a spinning globe.
A message from your friends at Globochem and the Globochem family of companies, makers of everything from...
For each item she names, we see a picture of the product.
Farm supplies.
A guy on a tractor.
To the bread you eat.
Suburban kitchen, kid eating a sandwich, mom smiling.
Surgical lasers.
Patient having a sex change with a laser.
Popcorn substitutes.
Couple in theater eating something weird.
Sewage treatment.
Large sewage treatment plant.
Sewage.
Sewage.
Rabbits.
Rabbits.
Relationship helpers.
Gay man modeling bondage gear for his gay mate.
Cancer research.
Scientists working on poison foam. This will matter later in the story.
From rock and roll posters.
Poster of a rock band.
To leisure wear.
A sweatshop in China.
Globochem fills your world with things.
An animated Pit-Pat pops up in the lower corner and waves.
Wherever you see Pit-Pat, you know you are part of a wonderful worldwide corporation.
Take it from me! I love you!
And a final sting that is suddenly somewhat ominous.
Globochem. A better world for better people.
Dip to black and up on interior backstage. We are in a small ramshackle backstage area. Mirrors with lots of burned out bulbs around them. Music in the background is pre-show circusy music. Bob and David are warming up for a show. Bob is dressed in a flashy, furry, red, white, and blue 70s pimp outfit. David is wearing a foam map of America. His hat is Alaska and his feet are Hawaii.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.